Call 1-800-807-4575 and reserve your copy of NBC's 2002 Olympic Highlight Video. All the great moments from the 2002 Olympic Winter Games. The NBC 2002 Olympic Highlight Video is a tape to be treasured. Just $19.95 plus shipping. Call 1-800-807-4575.
Back at Park City, the leader, Anya Pearson, already with at least a bronze medal. Two racers to come, Alexandra Meissnitzer and Janica Kozelic, the two fastest from run number one. The Austrian has a nearly four-tenths advantage carried over from her time in run number one.
And the Austrian women, surprisingly, with only two medals so far in these games, none of them gold. Meissnitzer had a fourth place in the pre-Olympic giant slalom coming in here. Then she got fourth in the Super-G and Snow Basin. Believe me, she would not be happy with another fourth. She's lost some of her advantage there, Tim. And remember, it's warm up on top, and that top flat is just getting baked. It could be that it's slower, making it far more important to nail these steeps down below for the later racers.
No margin for error now for Meissnitzer. Watch this split time, the combination of run one and the time to here, and she's lost even more, 1/100th, her only advantage.
She told me she's not in the shape that she'd like to be because of her bad knee. She can't take the amount of runs that she'd like to, and that's got to affect her down here in this giant slalom. It is the most taxing of events.
Now she's fallen well back, over 3/10.
She's got to be light on her skis, and that's very hard to do when you're tired.
Giving it all she's got down here. Meissnitzer to the finish line and into third place, 6/10 out. On the bubble for bronze, and Anya Pearson knows she has at least a silver. One racer still to come. Janica Kozelic, 20 years old like Pearson. So calm. Look at this lineup. She's got three medals already. One more makes her the greatest racer of all time in terms of Olympic medals. The names: Keeley, Seiler, Katja Seitzinger, Omad, who's been a star in the men's alpine events at these games at age 30 from Norway. Croatian flags waving. There's her mom, Marica. Gotta be excited one more time. She's already seen her daughter win a pair of golds and a silver. And she's got more than 8/10 as her advantage for the second run. Gold is definitely a possibility the way she's been skiing in these games.
And no one would have pegged her to be a player in this event, no better than 10th so far this season. But she seems to be able to do no wrong.
Kozelic now ready to dive down that first pitch. First split time coming. And she's lost a little bit of time on the top. Kozelic lost about 2/10.
We talked about how that top flat seems to be slowing down with the sun, but Kozelic has been so good in the technical parts of all of these events, just right on with her technique.
Looks like it here too, solid turns.
Picking
it back up.
She picked it back up. Hard to believe she had three knee surgeries in the off-season, and she can be skiing like this, just taking it to the world.
Now down onto the second pitch, you can see the finish line. Crowd coming alive for her. Kozelic, look at this skiing down here, letting him run here. She doesn't have to do this. She's got that advantage, remember. She's flying to the line. Kozelic, the crowd alive, and she's got gold again. Her third gold medal by more than a second. Her best ever finish in GS. And look what she's done. That is Pearson over there with her, what's obviously a genuine hug. Mom, boy, I tell you what, she's thanking the Lord above. Another gold medal. And that makes her the first skier to win four medals in a single games, Coach.
And she did it with superior technique and high riding confidence. Look at how her hip just kissing the snow there, her feet split apart to allow the hips to sink down and deliver pure power to the edge. Turn after turn, look, there's another smile. It's gotta feel good.
I guess so. I tell you what, if there was a downhill tomorrow, I wouldn't bet against Kozelic in that. You've been watching a real phenom, and there she is, happily waving the Croatian flag. You know there's a party there again tonight. Gold to Kozelic, silver to Pearson, bronze to Sonia Knepp. Here's the champion with our Todd Brooker.
You know, just merely saying congratulations to you doesn't do justice to the way you've skied and the accomplishments you've made here. Did you ever dream that all of this was possible?
No, really. Especially, I don't know, GS, I haven't skied good. And usually I always had trouble with the first and second run, when it was good, when it was bad. So I was thinking, if this gonna run, it's gonna be second run bad. I was like, okay, whatever, but I got the 3 medals.
What a privilege it has been, and what a treat we have had watching this young woman share her skill and her joy with us during these games. An Olympic alpine record-setting 4 medals in 4 events, 3 of them gold. Here's to you and your family, Yanitsa Kostelic.
All right, Tim, and you think about tiny Croatia, a decade removed from a difficult transition to independence, but through it all, a passion for sports has endured there. More proof now, as word comes from Zagreb of plans to build a statue honoring Croatia's skiing sensation, Yanitsa Kostelic. Up next, back to the figure skating gala and the performance by 17-year-old Californian Sasha Cohen.
Here's tonight's winner of a 1-year package of home telephone service provided by AT&T in the AT&T Perform Without Limit sweepstakes. Log on to NBCOlympics.com for more details.
Dad, are we there yet?
No.
Podemos acompañarnos.
Yo quiero llorar.
Surfing in the lemon one.
Surfing in the lemon one.
Family vacation on the wings of Goodyear.
Oh, the wonderful thing about children is it never occurs to them that their dreams might not come true. My dream has come true. With hard work and some good financial advice, I just opened my 3rd childcare center. We take care of hundreds of children every day. Our children.
Major international competition, it's pretty amazing. You'll be hearing a lot to come from Sasha Cohen.
I know a secluded place, a place where no one knows your face, a glass of wine. Embrace. It's called Hernando's Hideaway. All you see are silhouettes, and all you hear are castanets, and no one cares how late it gets. Now at Hernando's Hideaway.
Why?
match, and you will know you're in.
She is truly something special.
What a talent. This is only the beginning of a magnificent career.
Sasha Cohen.
Still to come, 2 weeks shy of his 40th birthday, German bobsled legend Christoph Langen takes aim at a Salt Lake sweep. And later, a figure skating finale, including performances by all three medalists from last night's ladies' competition. That's all ahead on NBC. AT&T presents Perform Without Limits. Last night, Sarah Hughes had the performance of a lifetime to win a surprise figure skating gold.
Gold medal! What an upset! What an unexpected result! What a deserving gold medal performance!
AT&T encourages you to perform without limits.
For 4 years, we were together every minute. These days, I see him maybe once a year. But just get two of us on the phone, and there's a party going on.
Introducing a new concept in long distance. AT&T Unlimited. $19.95 a month for unlimited long distance calls to any other AT&T residential long distance customer. All 50 million of them. No matter what plan they're on. Just call 1-800-REACH-OUT to enroll in AT&T Unlimited. And for $19.95, make all the calls you want. Talk as long as you want. Whenever you want to AT&T customers. Plus, it's just 7 cents a minute to anyone else.
Today, we're spread out everywhere. L.A., New York. But you'd be surprised how often we find ourselves back in that house.
Let your long distance be unlimited. Enroll in the AT&T Unlimited plan. 1-800-REACH-OUT or att.com/unlimited.
Let me tell you how it will be. It's one for you, 1940.
It's estimated Americans overpaid $311 million in taxes. That was $610 for each taxpayer. That $610 could have been yours. Now H&R Block will double-check last year's tax return free. We can refile past returns. You could get more money back.
Aren't you going to answer those?
If I do, I miss the game. I hate to miss the game.
Uh-huh. You know, if you had TiVo, you could pause your TV so you wouldn't have to miss the game.
Really?
Uh-huh. Gee, aren't you and your wife expecting a baby?
Any minute now.
Pause and rewind live TV. Now TV fits into your life, not the other way around. TiVo, TV, and unexpected emergencies your way.
I hope he doesn't forget again.
Michelob Light. Anniversary.
You got the pizza, right?
The great taste of Michelob Light makes any occasion seem special.
When it comes to racing on ice, luge is the speedy go-karts, skeleton the out-of-control dirt bikes, and two-man bobsleds are the sports cars. Now get ready for the human-powered rockets.
Legs get it started, but guts take it through a course with 15 curves at speeds up to 90 miles per hour. Talk about pressure. How about a G-force you thought only space-bound astronauts felt? Length of mission, less than 47 seconds. And hold on, because this rocket doesn't have seatbelts.
The usual 15,000 fans on hand at Utah Olympic Park for run one of the four-man competition. Our first sled, France won, and driver Bruno Mangin.
The French coming in here as an underdog, and they are very confident that they could steal a medal. He's a defending bronze medalist from the Nagano Winter Olympic Games. Won the last World Cup event of the year in his on his home track in Lapland, and they have a lot of confidence in this sled.
John, this is a four-run total time competition over two nights, and the weather may very well play a factor.
Yeah, this is warmer than what it was last weekend when I said it was the warmest bobsled competition since Calgary in 88. This is causing havoc with the people who are going to put runners on these sleds. They don't know what to do. Temperatures are almost in the 50-degree mark, which is unheard of.
Last night we witnessed 17,000 people roar with cheers one moment, sit in silence the next. We've never seen anything like it, and we may never again.
And Jim Serra's part of that gala skating exhibition tonight at the Salt Lake Ice Center, but what drama, some of it unexpected last night, huh?
It's so lonely out there too, you know?
That's pressure, at least in the context of sports, that's pressure. And that young lady was up to it. We're back after this.
After 8 years as friends, Joey's fallen for Rachel. Everyone else knows.
I'm sorry, did you just say you like Rachel?
Yes.
What am I gonna do?
Thursday, he'll finally tell her.
I'm falling in love with you.
A must-see episode of Friends, NBC Thursday.
TV Guide calls NBC's new comedy Leap of Faith the post-Friends friend worth watching.
What an honor.
Yeah, that's good, because Leap of Faith premieres this Thursday after Friends on NBC.
Lee Nissan Pontiac of Enfield offers you the best deals on new cars, trucks, and SUVs in the state. We guarantee it or you get $500. Save up to $4,000 on all new Nissans and Pontiacs. Lease a new 2002 Nissan Altima for as low as $199 a month. Get finance rates as low as 0.9%. We have over 200 new and pre-owned certified cars available. We'll match or beat any new vehicle price in the state. Guaranteed. Or we'll give you $500. Lee Nissan Pontiac. Leader in automotive since 1977.
At Leaf Guard of Connecticut, this is our guarantee. You will end cleaning out your gutters forever. Leaf Guard rain gutters feature the most advanced design in over 40 years. The unique hood cover trough deflects leaves and debris while keeping water flowing freely. And Leaf Guard is the only one-piece no-clog gutter that is installed without lifting your roof shingles. Find out why Leaf Guard is the number one selling leaf shedding system in America. Call Leaf Guard today for a $100 discount coupon. End cleaning out your gutters forever, guaranteed. 1-800-814-5323.
We're going to the mile. Your Sunday at this point looks like a very nice day with a good deal of sunshine. Weekend mornings, when you want the local weather forecast, there's only one place to turn. The 22 News Storm Team, especially when the weather gets rough. Know that we are here. On with the area's only live Doppler radar. Following the storms, ready to advise you on your weekend plans. So relax. The 22 News Storm Team doesn't take a break, not even on weekend mornings.
The 22 News Storm Team is working for you. 22 News tonight.
Is pedophilia curable, as one local religious leader says? Find out if it's possible or if it's a permanent disease. Global tensions are on the rise. How America's new overseas aggression affects the volatility and what local citizens feel about continuing U.S. presence in foreign lands. An unseasonable weather pattern continues across New England. Will you need sunglasses or sweaters this weekend? The 22 News Storm Team keeps you prepared.
Tonight, 22 News, working for you.
Utah Olympic Park has been good to the USA with four medals in the past 3 days. Now here in the four-man competition, the Americans lead after run one. Brian Scheimer in fifth place.
He had the best speed of any sled on the track. He also had the 17th best start time, 4:87 in the first team. Mike Kahn, Doug Sharp, Dan Steele, 4:86, they got improved. Now the ice is firmer, and Scheimer shows what these Bodine sleds can do on this super speedway here at Utah Olympic Park. almost 87 miles an hour. The only other sled near that was Todd Hayes, and the other Bodine sled, which is a mirror of this one, he had 86.1. No other sled in the competition broke 86 miles an hour.
Scheimer has won World Cup championships, world championship medals. He's won everything but an Olympic medal, and he's come very close.
And this is where this bottom part of the track where the Bodine sled starts to fly. If he's straight here, he will be our leader, and he is.
Around the finish, Brian Scheimer, yes, by 300s, he moves into the lead ahead of Langen and the Germans. So the USA out in front, another American sled still to come. We're down to our final four sleds here in run number two out of four. This is Swiss number one, driver Martin Onnen, the bronze medalist in the two-man competition.
Broke the track record at the start in the first heat, 473. If things go the way things go for Switzerland, he'll be 472, 471.
Things have gone for Switzerland to the tune of 14 medals in their Olympic four-man history.
Good teams get better in the second run, especially up here when temperatures have dropped. There it is, 472, another track record. The Swiss, they don't look like the athletes that the Americans and Germans have, but boy, are they precision starts. Got a very big lead on Scheimer. It's 3,500s ahead. And that 3,500s will increase until the bottom part of the track where Scheimer's Bodine sled was just flying.
Still ahead, another Swiss sled, a German sled, and American Todd Hayes, but this is Swiss one, 3,500s up at the medium point.
33, you can see he's losing time back to Brian Scheimer.
86 miles an hour around the finish. He lost a little time, but enough to hold on to the lead, 3/10 ahead of the American, John.
1,300s he beat Scheimer at the start. Bobsledding, we say that's a multiplier three at the bottom. So really, Scheimer outdrove him all the way down the track. Scheimer did not have the start in the first 50 meters, but this guy did. He set a track record for the second consecutive heat in the first 50 meters. The key here is watch the way these Swiss athletes get in this sled. Watch how quickly they're in. We say get in, sit down with cat-like movements. If you put a clock on them, I bet you they're in the sleds quicker than anybody else.
Switzerland won with the lead. We move back to the top of the track for Germany sled number two. This was not the Germany sled most people figured to be in the top three after one run, but Andre Lange and company had a great first heat. They're just 0.06 of a second out of the lead.
You know, he's German, so you expect him and Lange to have a great relationship. They don't. Lange is from Saxony, which is the old East Germany, and Langen is from Bavaria. Langen has this tremendous Bavarian arrogance and doesn't have a great relationship with his teammate. In fact, Langen's got a better relationship with the United States, Todd Hayes. Langen also has some great start people. 475 in the first heat. He should go under that. 475, he at least matched it. Good teams at least match their start times. Best teams get better.
This driver has the track record, 46.57. He set it a year ago, winning a World Cup event here in Park City.
Plus seven behind Onnen. This top four sleds are separated by 0.07 of a second. He's lost more time, and now he's going to have to be perfect, or he'll give up at least one spot to Martin Onnen of Switzerland. Plus eight. Only chance he's got is to be perfect right here. He flat, plus four. He is coming on.
Around the finish here is Germany two, and they're in a dead heat, as John just said, tied with the Swiss sled for first place with just two sleds remaining here in run number two. John Morgan, these are 1,400-pound rigs these guys are flying down the track on. How do they push them, let alone control them?
Well, it's about athleticism, precision, and watch the runner spray here. And he's trying to get over to the left-hand side of our screen to get on the takedown to the corner so he doesn't have to steer so much in the next corner. And he must have done something right because he came back on the bottom part of the track.
With two sleds remaining here in run number two, there's a tie for the lead. The Americans coming up.
NBC's coverage of the 19th Olympic Winter Games is brought to you by the all-new Saturn View, at home in almost any environment. By Delta, official airline of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games. by Papa John's Pizza. Better ingredients, better pizza. And by Zoloft, official supporter of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games.
You know when you can't get over something traumatic from your past. You're unable to feel. You get overly startled and may have trouble sleeping. You may even feel like it's happening again. Your daily activities and relationships suffer. You know you just can't put it behind you. Now here's something you may not know. These are some symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder, a serious medical condition affecting over 13 million Americans. While the cause is unknown, PTSD may be related to an imbalance of naturally occurring chemicals between nerve cells in the brain. Zoloft, a prescription medicine, works to correct this imbalance. When you know more about what's wrong, you can help make it right. Only your doctor can diagnose this anxiety disorder. Zoloft is not for everyone. People taking medicines called MAOI shouldn't take Zoloft. Side effects may include dry mouth, insomnia, sexual side effects, diarrhea, nausea, and sleepiness. Zoloft is not habit-forming. Talk to your doctor about Zoloft, the number one prescribed brand of its kind. Zoloft. When you know more about what's wrong, you can help make it right.
You still here?
How's she doing?
I don't know how to say this, Mr. Foley. It's gonna cost you a fortune to put her through college.
Look at it this way. She's premature. You've got a 6-week head start.
Hi. Ben. Fred.
Introducing the nimble, all-wheel drive Saturn V, at home in almost any environment.
American Todd Hayes on deck, hoping to end a 46-year medal drought for the USA in Olympic bobsled, but this is the second place sled after run number one. Christian Reich of Switzerland, silver medalist in the two-man.
Picked up the sled, look at the way that sled came out of those grooves. That is a mistake worth a couple hundred, 477 in the first heat. 479. That's at least a couple hundreds, and there's a push bar out. That's not only dangerous, that is no time.
That's the bar used to push the sled at the top. It could hit any wall. It could cause all sorts of havoc.
That's worth a half a second if he catches that on one of these lifts. He doesn't know it's out. I can't believe one of his teammates doesn't see it's out. This is disaster for a team that's usually known for precision. 1800s down. Obviously, it's not aerodynamic. Still dangerous down here where it's fast.
He's been driving well, staying near the center, John.
Watch this, 2600's down. He's lost everything here. He just threw a medal away.
2900's in back of the pack. In fact, in pack of the top two sleds and in effect out of the medals, John.
Watch them start shaking their heads here. They can't figure it out. How come this thing didn't come down? These are specially designed. First of all, look at this mistake. This is called being too pumped up. When you pick those runners up out of those grooves there, bobsledding is about going forward, not up.
Final sled, first round leader, Todd Hayes up at the top with the Bodine sled. Earlier, we talked to the man behind the sled.
And I was pretty naive about bobsledding. These things are a lot more complicated than what I thought when I took my first ride at Lake Placid. You know, I just thought it had four runners and a little body and that's all, but there's a lot to them and, you know, people need to understand that. They're a real race machine. I've ridden and I've driven, and I'd rather be in that race car strapped in anytime than being in a bobsled going down this run.
Incidentally, a Bodine sled has already won a gold medal at these Olympics. Jill Bakken and Vanetta Flowers in the women's competition, and they sizzled down the track. And John, that's just what Todd Hayes and USA One will need to do to hold on to their lead.
Well, he hit a home run in the first heat.
and he's going to have at least an extra base hit here. He wants to send the Europeans to bed tonight, knowing that they know that Todd Hayes is for real, and it's all about right here. 472, 473 is a big-time statement to the Europeans. 474.
On the sled with Hayes, Randy Jones, Bill Schuffenauer, and Garrett Hines.
Now, he didn't have the speed that his teammate Brian Scheimer had in the identical Bodine sled, but he had the second-best speed. And if he has that type of speed in the bottom part of the track, he will go to sleep tonight in first place. Minus three. He's lost time back. Had a skid there. Next clock could be even. No, he's holding it. That's a perfect sign. Now in the straightaway. If this thing comes right down the middle, and he's gaining more time on the bottom part of the track.
Todd Hayes in USA 1 will have the lead midway through this four-man competition. They have positioned themselves to be in a place where no American sled has been in nearly half a century.
Craig Sands, the coach, very confident looking. I think Todd Hayes is unfazed. Here he is out of Albert's Alley, the pivotal part of the track. Look how clean this is. No spray off the runners. He's on a little tap there in the back, but he's on the perfect part of that corner to exit for perfect speed.
So while USA 1 and Todd Hayes have the lead, right now we send it down to Lewis Johnson with a report on the pre-race favorite.
All right, Tim, thanks so much. A developing story here. After the German team finished their second run, I saw Christoph Longen walking around with a visible limp. As a matter of fact, he was favoring his right leg, and at one point, he actually put some snow and ice inside his sock and pulled it back up. Don't know how serious it is, but we'll follow it throughout the night and give an update on it tomorrow. Tim?
All right, thanks, Lewis. It's been 46 years since the USA has medaled at the Olympics. But with Todd Hayes in first place, that drought may, just may, end tomorrow.
Still to come from Salt Lake City, final performances by the newly crowned Olympic figure skating champions. A golden gala on ice ahead as coverage of the 2002 Winter Games continues on NBC.
Moo.
Gateway's gold medal savings event is in full swing. So come into a Gateway store and talk to one of our friendly computer experts about incredible deals, like the 300 SE. It's got an Intel Celeron processor, a CD burner, and a monitor, all for only $599. So call us at 1-800-GATEWAY or stop by one of our stores for Gateway's gold medal savings event today. That's 1-800-GATEWAY.
Brown makes work easy. Brown helps me get it done. Brown keeps track of my addresses. Brown tells people their shipments are coming. Brown even prints the labels for me. Brown takes care of me. I love Brown.
Desktop shipping made easy. What can Brown do for you?
Just how much can you tap into with an AT&T broadband connection? Try over 100 channels of entertainment. All the phone lines a house could want. And oh yeah, internet that flows by the gallon. Hope you're thirsty.
Of course, everyone has the right to be published, but the odds are against you. Why? Money. A publisher must commit thousands of dollars for an initial...
That's not exactly true. With on-demand publishing technology, everything's digitized. People can even print one book at a time and forget warehousing, so now everyone here can get published. Yeah.
Well, for the second straight Olympics, Michelle Kwan arrived as the favorite and then was stunned by a rising teenager. Nonetheless, over time, she's been a great skater, a great and gracious champion, And that ought to be reflected in the reception she receives over at the Ice Center during the exhibition gala. Let's go back over there now and join Tom Hammond.
And the roar is for Michelle Kwan. Once again forced to put her Olympic disappointment aside and once again handling it all with dignity and grace. And the fans still love it.
Everyone here is standing for her. Success isn't always measured by a gold medal.
Tears of joy, tears of sadness, more than a little irony, as she stated, to Fields of Gold.
We watch with a heavy heart. So many people wanted her to have that medal, but she won the bronze. She She's been on the Olympic podium twice, and that shows great longevity and wonderful integrity. What a champion.
Tuesday, NBC presents to you
The Gift of Frasier.
Two Frasiers. First, a special early Frasier at 8, 7 Central, followed by the big premiere of Watching Ellie starring Julia Louis-Dreyfus. Oh! Then another all-new Frasier with Michael Keaton.
Yeah!
Followed by an all-new Scrubs. Got it?
I'm just trying to get the sequence right.
Okay, first, an early Frasier at 8, the premiere of Watching Ellie, another all-new Frasier, and an all-new Scrubs. It all happens Tuesday on NBC.
The Leah Auto Group is proud to announce the newest dealership in New England, Leah Hyundai in Enfield, Connecticut. We're celebrating our grand opening the whole month of February with deals like these. 2002 Hyundai Accents for just $79.95. Or 2002 Hyundai Elantras for $11.995. All coming with America's best warranty. We're so confident with our prices that if we can't beat the competition, we'll pay you $500. Guaranteed. Celebrate Leah Hyundai's grand opening in Enfield. We're just minutes from Springfield.
You've waited all year, now it's here. It's Piraway's once-a-year 0% interest sale. Piraway's, always the low price. West Springfield and just over the bridge in Ludlow.
At Gary Rome Hyundai, you get award-winning service and the Hyundai Advantage. 10 years or 100,000 miles. It's America's best warranty, right, buddy?
The 22 News Storm Team is working for you.
Raymore Flanagan Furniture presents something wonderful. A monumental event when great furniture values align with phenomenal financing. First, enjoy store-wide savings on living rooms, bedrooms, dining rooms, and more, including famous brand names at every Raymore and Flanagan location. And then the incredible financing until 2004. No deposit required, no interest to pay. Financing is interest-free until... And no deposit, interest, or payments for one full year.
No lie, George. This is a great sale. Should redecorate the White House.
The what?
Raymore and Flanagan's President's Day sale. Now through 9 p.m. Monday.
Is this coming cherry?
Do you wish remodeling your bathroom could be quick, clean, and affordable? BathFitter can make it happen. Financing is available with fast, easy credit approval and payments starting as low as $59 a month, or use 90 days, same as cash. Don't wait another year to update your bathroom. Call now. Terms subject to credit approval. Call the professional. Call BathFitter at 1-800-440-6422. That's 1-800-440-6422.
Oh, what a dream. What a concept. Bernie's betting. Bernie sells betting. I know. It's got to be something really spectacular. How about a $399 pillow top, queen-size mattress and box spring with a free frame, 7-day-a-week free delivery, free removal of your old bed? Oh, that's incredible. Bernie sells bedding. What a concept. Oh.
It happens just once every 4 years. Now you can make the memories last a lifetime. Call 1-866-78-SKATE to order the 2002 Olympic Figure Skating Video Collection. Witness the emotional drama and dazzling beauty. All the skating magic from Salt Lake City can be yours forever. Call toll-free 1-866-78-SKATE.
We're back on a beautiful day in the Wasatch Mountains in Park City, Utah, where one American sled has already made it down the track, clinching a medal for the United States. Another USA sled set to go. Now, Duncan, of course, heading into the 1998 Winter Olympics, the USA had never won a medal in this sport. It was put up or shut up time, and they put up with not one, but two Olympic medals. Given that, would anything less than two this time around be construed as a disappointment?
I don't think less than two medals would be a disappointment, but it's very important that the U.S. program show that it was not a fluke that they got those medals. They're not just happy to be here. They came here to race.
4 years ago, that man, Chris Thorpe, won the Olympic silver medal. His partner was Gordy Scheer. Now the man looking somewhat tense, Duncan, behind him is his new partner, Clay Ives. They said their mission was onefold. win gold here. Right now they sit in the silver medal position, while their teammates down below have won the United States at least one medal here.
And that's got to help these guys, knowing that Grimet and Martin have just won a medal for sure. That's going to help their confidence going into this run. Thorpe has been in this position before. Even though they've said they want gold, I have to believe they're going to be happy with the silver medal also. Look for a good, powerful start. These guys are the fastest starters in the world. Look at the ice fly off the hands as they paddle down the ramp. That means they're really digging those paddles. Great start time.
Each of these athletes was married a couple of weeks apart last summer. You got to believe this is their final competitive race ever.
You would think so. Thorpe has had a long and, as we've seen, very successful career. Hopefully he can top that off with a gold medal here with Ives. They look very clean coming through the more difficult sections of this course. Let's see if they can just stay back, stay relaxed, and lay back towards the lower sections.
76 miles an hour, still straight down the middle of the track.
Beautiful job. Even though we can't see it, they have to be relaxed to keep that speed going.
They fall behind by 0.004 of a second. So the other American team of Mark Grimet and Brian Martin, who won bronze in Nagano, have clinched at least silver here. But the medal output has been doubled. Despite the frustration, Thorpe and Ives have also won a medal.
I think they should be very happy that they got on the podium. It's been a very difficult couple of years for them and a difficult season coming into this. Great job.
96 Olympic medals. The United States has been trying to improve with each subsequent games. They win silver and bronze in 1998, and now just one sled stands in their way in hopes of winning a gold. And Duncan, it was back in 98 that the Americans finished behind another German sled. Here are the two-time world champions, Leitner and Resch, going for the gold.
Now, Tim, Leitner, Resch do have a history of throwing down one incredible run and having a lot of trouble on the second run. But as we saw on their first run, they did have trouble, and they went very fast. If they put down a clean run, they might be very fast.
Well, their advantage is huge at that first split time, better than a tenth of a second, which is big in the sport of luge.
So far, they look very clean through 10-11. That's a tricky spot. Right now, they're coming into where they had trouble on their first run, into 13. Much cleaner through there. I have to believe that this is going to be a gold medal run. Whoa, trouble up into the finish curve.
This is going to be close right to the finish, and they do hang on by a tenth of a second.
It's amazing how they keep their speed right to the finish line.
So in what is a bit of a repeat of the Olympics 4 years ago, the Germans take the gold, the United States silver and bronze in the Olympic doubles luge competition.
This is incredible, Tim. Even with notable mistakes on that run, they found the speed and did it.
Talk about great debuts. In their first ever international race together, Leitner and Resch won the gold medal. That was at the 1999 World Championship. Now, 3 years later, their first Olympics, and they serve up the same result. Great drama for the final three sleds in the finish area. First, it was the Americans, Grimet and Martin. They came down in first place, ensuring themselves of a medal. Then their teammates, Thorpe and Ives, one place below them. So Grimet and Martin take the silver medal. They're with Mary Carrillo.
Obviously, you're going nuts here, and you got an upgrade from your last medal in Nagano.
Yeah, feels great to be silver. We've had a long string of bronze medals in world championships and everything, and it feels good to take one step higher.
Can you even describe what it's like to have to wait for that final German sled to come down to find out what color your medal's going to be?
Well, it was actually easier than waiting for the second run, that's for sure.
Does this mean you guys, 4 years from now, you might be wearing a little gold?
You know, you can always dream, can't you?
No doubt sweet dreams tonight for the Americans. Germany's count of 61 Olympic luge medals, downright impressive. The USA's count of a mere 4 is just as meaningful. Thanks to the double sliders, they've now doubled their medal output.
And Grimet and Martin's silver satisfaction is understandable after earning that breakthrough bronze in Nagano. The third place thing was getting old in a hurry. It happened again at the 99 and 2000 World Championships for them. So today, it's their best result ever at a major event, not just any major event, the biggest, the Olympics. We'll be back.
is starting a pizza company using quality ingredients.
I'm so scared.
Some said a better pizza wouldn't catch on.
People love Papa John's.
Using their expensive sauce, they'll never last.
For 17 years, you've helped us prove that better ingredients make a better pizza. And to celebrate our 17th anniversary, we're offering you two large, one-topping pizzas for only $12.99. It's our way of saying thanks to you. Better ingredients,
better pizza.
Papa John's.
I've got the driest skin of anyone I know.
St. Ives' new intensive healing softens even the driest skin.
I've always wanted legs I could show off.
St. Ives' firming lotion firms as it softens.
I've got to find a lotion that smells great.
St. Ives' new cucumber melon gives you a cool, light fragrance as it softens. No matter what you need, only St. Ives offers a guarantee of an immediate 200% more moisture for touchably soft skin.
I've found my St. Ives.
Brown makes me feel powerful. Brown lets me be everywhere all at once. Brown software connects me to my suppliers. It connects me to my customers. Brown brings me my raw materials. Brown delivers my finished goods. I trust Brown. Other colors may be cute, but they don't call you back.
Making business more efficient. What can Brown do for you?
Is there really a secret method twins use to communicate? Well, yes. It's called Speed Dial.
Introducing AT&T Unlimited. $19.95 a month for unlimited long-distance calls to any of AT&T's 50 million residential long-distance customers. Make all the calls you want, whenever you want. Plus, it's just 7 cents a minute to anyone else.
It is weird, though. I come home at night, think of something that I want to call her about, and the next thing you know, the phone's ringing.
Call 1-800-REACH-OUT to enroll.
It's good. Good, good, good. Hey, Michelle, that's great. Really beautiful and poetic and all this stuff. But the part where you do the spin thing, if you could just kind of turn and stop here like this.
And if you could hold that for a couple minutes, that'd be great.
You know, there's one last thing. Really need you to hit this spot.
Oh, yeah, that's critical.
Chevrolet sponsors the 2002 U.S. Olympic team all year long. And it shows. Chevy, day in, day out, we'll be there.
Chevrolet. Proud sponsor of the 2002 U.S. Olympic team presents Chevrolet Olympic Moments.
And when you hear that music and that introduction, that means it's time for Jimmy Roberts.
Bob, how are you?
Okay.
We had an Olympic moment today. It was just not the kind we could have possibly foreseen. Once again, because of figure skating, sports made news, and the news was unprecedented. In 1994, Tonya Harding and Nancy Kerrigan made worldwide headlines, but in point of fact, that whole mess really happened at the U.S. National Championships in Detroit. This judging flap happened on the biggest stage that sports knows, a stage not unfamiliar with things that reverberate well beyond the world of sport and prompt change. Today was the day that the Olympic Games leaped off the sports page, because what happened had never happened. They say you can't change history, but that's just what the IOC did.
We received an official proposal from the International Skating Union to award a gold medal to Sale and Pelletier. The executive board of the